Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. This is CMA Anshika Tyagi. So before starting this video, I would like to give my little bit of introduction just because this video is related to foundation students and maybe few foundation students who is new in the CMA did not know me. So I would like to a little bit small introduction about myself. Besides CMA Anshika Tyagi, I'm a qualified cost and management accountant, that is CMA, and also I'm a member of Institute of Cost and Management Accountant of India. I'm also having a degree, that is CPFA, I should say. I got the designation of Chartered Public Finance and Accounts. I got this degree from the Chartered Institute of Public Finance and Accountancy, which is a UK-based, I should say, that is, it is a London-based institute, which provide a globally recognized degree. So I'm a globally recognized, I am also having a globally recognized degree. And as about my achievements is, one good achievement is I got clear my CMA at the age of 21, which were considered as the youngest CMA at that time in that attempt. And I'm currently working with the Rights Limited. Rights Limited is basically a PSU, that is public sector undertaking. And now few students maybe did not know about what does the PSU, or it may be you have studied this PSU word in your 12th standard, but this time you did not know recall the meaning of PSU. So in short, I should say that is where PSU is, where there is more than 51% holdings is in the hand of government. We should normally say that these PSUs is a government organizations. So that's all a little bit introduction about myself. And now this video I'm going to start. I'm making this video just because I'm getting a lot of queries from the CMA student side. Those students who is new in this course, and CMA foundation students having two main queries, which is common for each and every student. So just because these queries are the common queries, so I thought that I should make a video on this so that any of the other students who is having the same query, they can get the answer of their queries too. So the first question I'm taking, and very important question from the CMA student side, is, ma'am, will there be the negative marking in the exams which is going to be held on 6th of September 2020? So it's a very interesting question and very important questions. So the answer of this question from my side, I'm again repeating that this answer I'm giving from my side is because I thought the same. You, for clarification, you have to reach the, you have to contact in the institute for clarification, but it's my point of view. I will also give you the three reasons why I said this answer. So the answer of this question is no, there will be no any negative marking. So I'm again repeating that it's my point of view. Nowhere in the institute, nowhere from the institute side, it has clarified whether there will be any negative marking or not. So, but I'm giving the three reasons why I'm saying this. So the first reason is the notification released by institute side, which were on the, I think 9th of August, the 9th of August, the notification got released. At the time, I don't know, I did not recall the exact date, but the date on which the notification released for the foundation exam, that the exam for foundation is going to be online based, on MCQ based, and it will be held on 6th of September. So in that notification, if we read out the whole notification, nowhere it is mentioned that the MCQ based exam will be having the negative marking. So nowhere it is mentioned, when nothing is mentioned about negative marking, so there is no question arises to get the like, there will no any question arise that there will be implementation of the negative marking. So it's the first reason, it's the first perspective to say that there will be the no negative marking. Second perspective, it's my personal experience, just because I also write the computer-based test in the foundation in June 2015 attempt. At that time also, the institute were taking the exam through computer-based test. After, I think September 2015 attempt, again, the subjective type of exam start in the CMA also. Before than that, or earlier than that, that I should say that at in the CMA foundation, earlier than September 2015 or I think December 2015, earlier than that, there were the same pattern, right? Like computer based test. The only difference were that at the time also there were the computer based test, but the we need to write the exam or we need to give that exam by reaching to the exam center, and you people are writing this exam by sitting at your home. The only difference was that. So at that time also there were no any negative marking. So on the basis of my past experience, I can say that there will be no any negative marking in your exams. So the third question arises is, so the third perspective I should say, that if in any exam there is a negative marking, either it is the exam of banking or it's any of the exam or the government exam or any exam, if there is a negative marking, or I should take the example of CA Institute. When the CA Institute is taking the objective type CPT exam, earlier in the CA also there were the CPT were also the objective type. So in that exams, it would clearly mention that CA Institute were doing the negative marking. But at the time also CMA Institute were not doing the negative marking. So if there is a negative marking, it is clearly mentioned. So I can say that nowhere it is clearly mentioned that will there be a negative marking. Agar negative marking hoti hai, to clear mention kiya jata hai. Aur agar kuch mention na ho, hum deemed mante hain ki there will not be any negative marking. So these are the three perspective on the basis of which we can say that there will be the no negative. So the second question, it were the answer for the first query. Now the second query of the students is, ma'am, will the exam pattern will be the continue like in September 2015? September 2020, the exam is going to be computer based home test. And it will be totally objective type question. So the question arises, ma'am, will it be the continue for the future attempts like in the December 2020 or June 2021? So it's my personal answer. Nowhere it is announced from the institute said that in future also we will consider it as a we will take the exam on computer based test. But in my opinion, I also thought that again, if institute has started something, it will take it continue. Is because everything, if I talk about any exam which is the internationally level based, I should say that now I'm also doing a CIMA, that is Chartered Institute of Management Accountant. After completing that exam, I will go to the designation of Chartered Global Management Accountant. I'm also pursuing that exam, that course. So after clearing that, for the exam pattern for that course is also the online mode. So everything is going to be online, and also you know the quotation of Modi ji, that is I should say the digital India. So everything is going to be digitalized. So our institute is taking the initiative to take their exams digital on the basis of doing their exams the digitalized. So I thought that the exams will continue, the pattern will be the same. It may be that after the situation get okay, like just because of the COVID-19, the computer based test is the home based. The computer based test is going to be home based, but after the situation will be okay, it may be that the computer, there will be the pattern of the exam will be the same, but it will be computer based test at the center instead of computer based test at home. So there may be the difference. So I thought that in the future also the exam is going to take the exams on the online mode for the foundation. There nowhere inter and final exams about the inter and final exams, nowhere it is clear that will it be the online or not. This because there are too much problems in the inter and final exams. Like the institute have done the foundation exam as totally MCQ based, but inter and final exams is not totally the MCQ based. They are subjective and objective based questions. So it's not possible to write the 16 marks question on the laptop, and it's not possible to type the numerical questions in the laptop. So institute is searching about the substitutes. And maybe I think institute is also planning to do the inter exams and final exams also online mode. But let's see what will be the in the future. So that's all about everything. Again, I'm repeating, if any one of you having any doubt, I'm taking the live session on my YouTube channel on every Sunday. The address of my YouTube channel is, you can check out me and you can find me out on YouTube channel by typing CMA Anshika Tyagi. By the name of by my own name, I am having a channel, and which is specifically I have dedicated for the help of CMA students. There on every Sunday, I took the live session. In that live session, I get the each and every student's comments and reply, try to reply that their queries in a better and best possible manner. So if you're having any doubt, you can join me on YouTube and subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so that you can get the notification when I go live. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hopefully this video is very important and you should share this video with your friends also. Thank you so much for watching this video.